So they did post-mortem of their day. The Bible tells us in the book of John chapter 19 from verse 31, since it was the preparation day, the Jews did not want the bodies to remain on the cross on the Sabbath, for that Sabbath was a special day. They requested that Pilate have the men's legs broken and that their bodies be taken away. So the soldiers came and broke the legs of the first man and of the other one who had been crucified with him. When they came to Jesus, they did not break his legs, since they saw that he was already dead. But one of the soldiers pierced his side with a spear, and at once blood and water came out. He who saw this has testified, so that you also may believe. His testimony is true, and he knows he is telling the truth. Of course, the author of this passage was an eyewitness of this account. So what does that mean practically? What are some things that we can do as a result of this reflection? I would want to propose some few things. Number one, before the day is over, organize and have Holy Communion. Jesus commanded us that we are to proclaim his death until he returns again through having Holy Communion. So organize, get the emblems together. Whatever will represent the bread in your context, whatever will represent the cup in your context, and have communion with others. Number two, commit to walking in holiness. The Bible tells us in the book of Romans chapter 6 from verse 12, let not sin therefore reign in your mortal body to make you obey its passions. Do not present your members to sin as weapons of unrighteousness, but present yourselves to God as those who have been brought from death to life, and your members to God as weapons of righteousness. For sin will have no dominion over you, since you are not under law, but under grace. Grace is an amazing concept. And the idea of grace is not to give us permission to continue in sin, but rather to overcome sin. Titus chapter 2 from verse 11 says, for the grace of God has appeared, bringing salvation for all people, training us to renounce ungodliness and worldly passions, and to live self-controlled, upright, and godly lives in this present age, waiting for our blessed hope, the appearing of the glory of our great God and Savior, Jesus Christ. And lastly, tell somebody about this news. Tell them about the death of Jesus Christ. Chat with someone. Give them a call. Let's talk about the death of Jesus today. God bless you.